Hello Year 2 students, welcome back. My name's Ella and we are at lesson 34. So let's get to it. What will we need? We will need some measuring containers. We'll need some rice or sand, gum nuts, toys, even water because we'll be measuring today. And we need our hundreds, tens and ones. Okay, so let's get to our number talk. Today's number talk is brought to you by the number 351. Three hundreds, five tens, and one ones. Okay, let's make our number. We have three hundreds. Three hundreds. You can use your hundreds, tens, and ones ready made. Three hundreds. And five tens. Five tens and one ones. So this is what our number looks like. 300, five tens and one ones. 351. Okay, now we've made it. Let's think about a number bigger than that. Let's think about a number smaller than that. Okay. I wonder what your number is. My number, a number bigger than this, I'm going to say 500. 500 is bigger than 351. And for my number smaller than this number, I'm going to pick the number 5. 5 is smaller than 351. So we've made it and compared it to two different numbers. All right, brain switched on, away we go. Let's try our measurement activity. Time to make your own number. Have a think about a three-digit number. Make it, write it down, and give me a smaller and a larger number. Okay, while you're doing that, I'll get ready for our lesson. Today's learning intention is to measure capacity, to see how much something holds. We know we can do this when we can use a fair measure to see how much a container can hold. So what is a fair measure? Well, a fair measure is making sure that what I have got inside, what it's containing, is to the top. And I use my finger to roll across that. It's not halfway, it's not overflowing. A fair measure is right to the top. Okay, now for today's lesson, we're going to be measuring one container with three different containers or three different methods. All right, so you'll need to find one container you'll be using. I'm going to use these three containers to fill up my one I've chosen. So let's have a look and look at the differences between the three I have picked. We might describe these differences as this might be deep and narrow. This could be shallow and larger. And this could be similar to both of these. So it's quite deep and maybe this might be larger or maybe not. And that's today's lesson. We're going to measure the capacity in three different ways. Okay, how am I going to record this? I'm going to put it on a table again. And here's my table ready to go. So I've used my ruler and I'm going to think about how to estimate how many and what the total is. Okay, here we go. The first one I'm going to use is the blue laundry scoop. So using a fair measure, see how I pushed it across there? Right to the top, I've got one, fair measure, two, three, being quite careful here not to spill anything or make a big mess, three, four, five, getting a bit trickier now. Six, once again, a fair measure to the top. I think I could call this 6 and a bit. 6 and a bit. Oh, didn't estimate, but that's okay because I wasn't really sure. So for my laundry scoop, the total is 6 and a bit. Okay. And I haven't done an estimate, but I will for the next one. So let's have a look. 6 and a bit for my laundry scoop. Now I'm going to have a look at the differences here and make an estimate. Do I think I'm going to have more or less? This is a tricky one. I think I'm going to have more. I'm not sure, but I'll write my estimate as 10. Okay. Let's give it a go. Remember, a fair measure. Let's try again. A fair measure. 1. Try not to make a mess. 2. Oh, I'm not sure my estimate was right. 3. Actually, I'm very happy with 3. So 3 of these containers filled up my 1 container. Okay, let's record that. So this was my estimate. Was it a reasonable estimate? A little bit off. So the answer to that is 3. What a very interesting mathematical thought I've just had. This container and this container do have a relationship, don't they? 3 and 6. I know it's doubles. 3 and 6. There's a double there, isn't there? This is 6 and a bit. Okay, so very interesting. Let's think about my third container and the capacity. How much will this hold and how many do I need of these to fill my original container? Okay, so I'm going to have a look at what these differences are and have an estimate. Okay, I think I might choose 5. 5 is my estimate. 5 of these will fill up my container. Okay, let's give it a go. 1, 2, 3. Let's call it 3. Okay, so the answer is 3. Now, this is also a very interesting idea about capacity. Look, I can see that these two containers are actually the same. Their capacity is the same. The same amount of rice will fit into this container as that container. So, very interesting mathematical observation about capacity. What interesting mathematical observations we've made today. So let's reflect. We had a look at how to use a fair measure to see how much a container can hold. It's the capacity of the container. And we found some very interesting facts out, didn't we? These two containers have the same capacity. And look at this. This container has around about half of the capacity of these other two. Okay, very interesting, and some interesting observations about estimates as well. All right, I think you've guessed it. Your takeaway task today is to do your own mathematical observations about capacity without making too much of a mess. I'd like you to pick a container that you have and then 3 different containers to measure the capacity of your first container, making sure that it's a fair measure. All right, it's right to the top. It's not overflowing and there's not some space left over. Remember, if there is a little bit of space or a little bit more, you can add and a bit, okay, because that's an approximate measure. All right, so have fun. Capacity is a very interesting maths topic, isn't it? And I will see you at our next learning time. See you for now.